as we look ahead to this weekend's matchup against USC Aiken coming off of an overtime victory, what are some things that you and the team have been able to take from that win as we move forward to this weekend?
Well, hopefully just be a little bit solider defensively. And then rebounding. I was very happy with the rebounding. I think that's going to be a challenge on Saturday against Aiken. So those are two things we can build on. And we just got to be more consistent offensively, execute better, and make shots.
Do you feel that your team has made strides defensively over these last few games?
Yeah, I think for the most part we have. You know, again, I didn't think we had any huge breakdowns the other day. We did against Young Harris, but I didn't think we had any big breakdowns the other day. We were fairly solid, you know, trying to help a lot in the post and then try to get back to shooters because Augusta had a couple of good shooters and Aiken's got a lot of good shooters. So, you know, we're going to have to focus on contesting three-point shots.
Second time this season that you're taking on USC Aiken. Lost the first game. What are some things that you hope to improve upon heading into tomorrow?
I just thought the first game was a struggle, kind of on both ends of the floor. I thought it started out pretty well, and we were attacking their zone and getting the ball inside some and guarding reasonably well. They hurt us on the glass, which is a concern. Their last game was against Lander, and I think they hurt Lander on the offensive glass. We've got to do a better job of rebounding against them. They pose a problem where everybody can shoot the three. I mean, they won't even play a five sometimes and put stretch fours out on the floor where they can post a little bit. They can really come away and shoot the three. So, and do a great job of with their motion and do a good job of screening and cutting. So you're chasing all that stuff around and you've still got to worry about dribble penetration. You've still got to worry about offensive rebounding. So I think they will definitely test our defense. And then on the other end of the floor, they're going to most likely going to zone us. They zoned us pretty much the whole time last time. So we've got to do a good job of just not relying on the perimeter, but trying to get it inside. But then when we do, I think we can get perimeter shots, but we've got to be able to step up and knock down three-pointers.
Yeah, you mentioned a lot of zone defense in the last game. Do you feel that the difficulty, at least in the middle of the game, to score, was that due to more missing shots, or are they taking away good looks?
I think it was either our lack of execution a lot of times or our not making shots and maybe not getting the ball inside enough. And I think, you know, you see the zone defense, you're thinking, okay, we're going to get open perimeter shots. I think you've still got to attack it inside out. And, you know, getting the ball in the high to mid post I think is important. So, yeah, we need to work on that execution against the zone and then being ready to, like I say, we've got to knock down some shots. And I still don't think they're going to come out of the zone. If you make a three-pointer, I still think they're probably going to zone you because that's kind of their MO and that's what they do. But we've got to make some perimeter shots, obviously.
And what do you feel that your team needs to do well on Saturday to come away with the win?
A little bit of everything. You know, the one thing they hurt us last time is transition, finding shooters in transition. You know, they got some easy buckets in transition off three-point shots. We've got to get back and locate those shooters. We've got to do a good job of contesting three. They're going to make their share of contesting three and not giving up second shots. And then, like I say, just executing against their zone.
All right, Coach, thanks for your time. Best of luck tomorrow.
Thank you.